Hello, everyone, and welcome back to another feature here on the Keep Productive YouTube channel. My name is Francesco, and today we've got David Pierce from the Wall Street Journal on. Me and David just finished up doing a feature for the Tools They Use podcast, which will be available on YouTube as well for you to go and enjoy, because we did a video with it too. But David is going to take us through a really exciting application that we're both pretty interested at, which is Notion. And David did a great piece in WSJ. Maybe it was in March, wasn't it?
I think that's right, yeah.
Yeah, it was a great piece. I'll include it below for everyone who's listening along, all about how he uses Notion. And I guess progressively how Notion is changing the space. So David's actually going to share his Notion account for us today. So I think it's going to be quite exciting. So I'll pass over to you, David, to give you a tour.
All right. First, I'm going to figure out how to share my screen, which we will see.
See how this goes.
All right.
Can looks you, like it's
can
working.
You see my screen?
Yes, no. I can now. Yeah.
Yes. Okay. This is very exciting. Okay. So this is my Notion. It's relatively straightforward. I don't know if you feel this way, Francesco, but I find myself spending way too much time doing things like adding icons and covers to every page that I have. Does that, that sound right to you? Okay.
Yeah. I spent half an hour the other day doing it. Accident.
Yes, I have. I'm totally with you. And so I have basically three things. I'll walk you through how I do my to-do list in a minute, because that's where I've spent most of my time trying to figure things out. But basically the setup is trying to bring all of my personal stuff and all of my work stuff kind of into one place. So the personal stuff is relatively straightforward. That's me. That's a little David emoji, I guess. And this is basically just a rough list of sort of all the things going on in my life. This is like stuff I want to do in 2018. This is like a links for a Flipboard magazine I have that I keep forgetting to add stuff to. This is like, I travel a lot for work. So I don't know if this is updated or not. It should be. I need to put more things in the packing list. This is so like things that I want to do in California. And a lot of this, I'm still sort of in the process of moving over from Evernote. But one of the things I really like about this is that instead of just pasting links, it actually gives you this kind of stuff. So I can be like, oh, right, I do want to go to the Big Sur hotels. And then I just got married. So this is a mercifully short list now. But it used to be much longer and much more full of things. And that was my vows, which I will not show you. And then I have, this is things like my loyalty numbers for hotels and airlines. And one of the things I really like about it is I can just from any page, just go in and like type Delta, which, and then it'll show my Delta number. This is where I have tried so many times to keep something like a bullet journal in Evernote. And then again in Notion, and in either case, it hasn't really stuck, but I've always kind of liked the idea of having, I don't even know what's going to be actually. Yeah. So this was like, there was a while, especially when I was writing the piece where I was trying to keep sort of a day to day. This is actually the week I wrote about Notion. Okay. So this is actually a good example. So this is what I do for work is I have one of these pages for every story I write, basically. And so it's like, this is notes from a story or notes from something I read about business apps. These are notes from interviews that I did for it. This is information about different apps. And the fact that you can have these toggles in Notion is one of my absolute favorite things. The sort of collapsible bullets is just wildly helpful. And I have this set up as a template. So it'll give me these colors and these headers for everyone. So I can plan the video. I can outline the piece. These have gotten more full in pieces after that. I got better and better at Notion as time went on. So that's my personal stuff. And it's sort of increasingly filling up with recipes and things that I like. And I can just sort of jump into here anytime I need anything. The one thing that I try to be good at on the internet is anytime I see something I like, just saving it. And then eventually it'll come back and be useful to me again. And so that's not always true, but just having a place in here where I can dump stuff has been great. And the place where I dump stuff is this is the inbox, So this is a poorly spelled version of somebody told me I need to watch the show Person of Interest. So I'm going to. And then these are like links that are interesting or people that I think I should talk to. And we're having a party on July 28th. Everyone's invited. So that's that. And then this is actually for a column I'm writing right now with
people
I have interviewed for. This is like I'm writing about streaming music, and so this is a photo I spent way too long getting for the cover, and basically like stories and stats and notes that I've taken and people I interviewed and stuff like that. This inbox part is really important to me though, and it's setting up templates like this has been the best thing for me about Notion. I don't know if this has been your experience, but it's a little weird when you're just on a page to know where to put stuff. Hmm. So having a thing, especially on mobile, that I can just click and be like, don't forget to call dad. Just sort of sets it up as like, it just makes it easier to put new things in there. My favorite part where I spend too much time. What's up?
I was going to say, I really like the way that you're using the sort of emojis and also the colors of the headers. Do you change the colors of the headers then?
I do. I don't know if I do for all of them.
Probably like a template or something like that.
Yeah. Yeah. I think that's about right. Let's see. What's a good example? So I spend a lot of time. Do you know this website, unsplash.com?
I do. Yeah. Yeah.
I spend a lot of time on that site looking for these pictures.
Look great.
And I like them very much. So this is like shopping list for different things I need from different places. And then whenever I go somewhere and buy stuff, it all goes into there. And then eventually I'll just delete this page and start another one because I found that keeping completed things is not useful.
Yeah.
So then I also have a page for all the stuff I want to get to. And so this is, I think my favorite one is probably this one. These are like books that I would like to read. And so anytime somebody recommends a book, it goes in here.
Yes.
And then I can drop it into, okay, I need to read this. It's to read and it's nonfiction. And then it goes onto this list. And sometimes if I'm feeling really ambitious, I'll put an Amazon link. I finished this one, so I can go in there. And so this becomes sort of the tracker for everything I want to and am reading. And it's been incredibly handy because often I'll be like, I feel like reading something and then wind up just reading old books or watching old movies that I've already seen.
Yeah.
So it's been nice to have something that's like, oh no, here are the new things that you should be.
Yeah.
Which I like a lot.
I really like that. That's, to be honest, like my read one is so much, like I don't include the recommendations in there, but I think that's something that I've taken away from that straight away, just to include the recommendations. It's really neat.
Yeah, it's been really helpful for me. I mean, even the ones I don't end up taking, I delete stuff from this list without actually reading it all the time, but having just being able to be like, oh, right, that was that book that person was talking about. And it's back to sort of the same thing, just having this one place where everything that has been on my mind at one point or another is, even if I decide to get rid of it and never care about it again, just like that idea of like, what was that thing? The answer is always it's in Notion somewhere,
yeah,
which is wonderful.
Yeah.
I think, and then the last thing, I don't know how much of this I should actually show you, but this is where we're at. This is my sort of to-do list. And I have changed this a million times. I have used Notion has this great agenda thing that I really like.
Oh, yeah.
This one, which I have tried to use many times, but it has some awkward things and doesn't work super well for me. So I wind up back on something like this, which is more work to manage, but does the job. And this is all really the stuff neat I have to do today and later this week. Luckily, this list is starting to get short. These are like big projects I'm working on. And then having these reminders that have started to show up in Notion where it can actually like ping your phone when something is due has been a big change for me because it's one of the tricky things is like I've always thought about this with productivity apps. It's like, where do I put pay rent? Because I need to remember to do it and I need to remember to do it every week. And technically it's, you know, a thing. It is a task to do. But
yeah.
I never like, so having reminders for it has been huge.
They haven't released the recurring, have they yet? But that would just round it off, wouldn't it?
Yeah, I'm told it's coming. If they do recurring and then improve the calendar thing so it can actually integrate your calendar, I will just never leave Notion ever again.
They're looking at doing the API right next.
Yes.
That would change things, wouldn't it?
Yeah. When I met with them a while ago, he was talking about doing like a two-way Google Calendar sync. And I sort of freaked out sitting in their office just listening to him talk about it. So yeah, I mean, that's kind of the run of it. It's relatively, this is sort of a similar version of all the stuff I have for work, different meeting notes. And this is like, I went to a Sonos event and this is just like all the notes I took sitting there. And all of it is searchable. All of it is easily available. I can share individual pages. It's extremely handy.
I love it. I love it.
I remember to call Dad so I can delete that.
You've gone like much further than I expected. Like, I mean, I saw some of the screenshots in your article, but I was like, actually, this has made my Notion use look really weak.
Good.
And it's up my game. No, that's really, really insightful. Thank you, David, for taking
my pleasure. And I will say, can I offer one tip?
Oh, yes, please. Yeah.
The absolute best thing to me about Notion has been the different views of these boards and tables. And I feel like I'm only just starting to experiment with them and understand them. So like I have this one table of all of my tasks and I can group them in any way I need to and move stuff around and see it all in totally different ways. And it's just this like incredibly powerful tool, kind of unlike anything I've ever seen before. And you can like change how it's grouped and how you, what shows up. And I was with the Notion crew, they were showing me the how they do tasks and they have like 50 different views and it was just the wildest, most impressive thing I've ever seen. God. So that would be anybody who wants to like really go pro with Notion, start messing with that stuff.
I love it. That's amazing. Thank you, David. Where can everyone find you? Just as a round off note.
Sure. I am a personal tech columnist for the Wall Street Journal. So you can find me at WSJ.com and in the Wall Street Journal. I'm also on Twitter at Pierce. And I am always, always, always on Twitter. So you can find me there.
Lovely, jubbly. Thank you, David, for coming on. I'll include some timestamps as well so that people can skip forward. But it's been absolutely wonderful having you both on the podcast and on YouTube. So thank you, David.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Cheers.